third contest of the afternoon. Entering the battle arena cage first into the red corner. Make some noise for Elliot Winfield.
Now, Elliot Winfield's only 18 years of age. Can you imagine doing anything this scary when you were 18? It takes some bravery.
It takes a lot of bravery. It is, it's brave to step in the cage no matter what age, but being 18 years old as well.
Don't worry, Mr. Paul, he saved his arm.
He'll thank you later.
Definitely.
When he goes to write or use his phone or drive home and he realises his arm's still in one piece.
Now, Elliot Winfield, he's studying sports therapy at uni. And that knowledge is going to be really helpful in preparation for a fight. He's going to be able to understand peaking, understand keeping his body in check, mobility, and he can use a lot of those skills in his training. And then he's got Gavin Stewart, recent 10th Planet black belt, and Mick Broster. No, it's such a, any Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt is so hard to get, but 10th Planet, it's one of those such high standards. Eddie Bravo won't just let anyone have it. You got to train with him quite a lot. There's like certain criteria you have to live to.
Oh, wow.
And Gavin Stewart, and then immediately went out, competed at black belt and won a gold medal in a local competition, beating other black belts. So.
Congratulations.
Yeah. And he's got Chris the Knee Me, who's the striking coach over at 10th Planet Banbury. So they kind of split the responsibilities between the grappling coach and the striking coach. And then they get together and between the two of them coach the fighters. And it's a relationship that seems to really work well for them.
Good little dynamic duo then.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, look at 18 with the bod.
Jesus,
not fair.
He's looking in shape.
He can't find the right corner though.
No, but it's cool. I'll let you wander. 18 years old, fair play.
And his opponent entering the cage into the blue corner.
He looks in shape though, he looks ready and prepared.
Really does.
Winyaski.
This come from...
I think Winyaski's got Andre Winner on his corner. It's certainly part of his coaching team. He's got Andre Winner. There he is, Andre Winner. I predicted it.
Yeah, Andre Winner. Is that James Dixon as well?
So the Lions Gym Collective up there in Coventry. They have Gracie Baja Coventry, which fights out of Lions Gym. They have Andre Winner, who does a lot of the coaching duties on the MMA program. And for our listeners at home, Andre Winner, UFC veteran, tough veteran, one of the most widely respected fighters and coaches on the UK MMA scene. And having someone like that in your corner has got to give you confidence.
I remember watching him on the Ultimate Fighter, UK versus USA.
Yep. And tapped Ross Pearson, if I remember, on the show.
Yes. Very,
it's very impressive because Ross went
very high level. Very high level fighter and coach.
Yep. I know they bring fighters to a lot of battle arena shows, and often I'll see Andre backstage and have a little chat to him. He's the nicest guy.
Yeah. That's cool.
There's an assumption that with these professional fighters, these monsters, that they're gonna be not the friendliest, but apart from Jimmy Wallhead, they're all lovely. I'm joking, Jimmy. Oh, this is Battle of the Bods. Shredded.
What's this weigh? 70 kilos.
Big body shame.
Introducing first the fighter in the red corner. Weighing 70.2 kilograms. Representing 10th Planet, Banbury, and the striking clinic. Make some noise for Elliot.
So the prediction from Elliot Winfield's corner was that he was going to win, but on the ground. Apparently he's a very good grappler, but also likes high kicks.
Going from literally one extreme to the other.
But if you're not worried about being taken down, it gives you the freedom to throw the head kicks. That's one of the things.
Much more confidence.
Yeah. I like the intensity from both fighters.
Yeah, they don't seem to be breaking stare.
Elliot Winfield, that's a terrible beard. All right, here we go. Elliot Winfield in the 10th Planet green and black shorts, and Jack Winyaski in the red and black.
Lovely outside kick.
It's those high kicks we were told about. Both fighters are opting to start off with the feet. Nice body shot. Oh, lovely inside kick. Gives one back. It's one of the things with the striking clinic over there in 10th Planet Banbury. They're not just one style. Chris Mee does a really good job of putting different styles of striking together. Inside leg kick, goes high.
Elliot's looking good so far.
Yep.
Looking calm, composed.
And Yaskew's dangerous to that right leg. It's lightning fast.
Oi.
I mean, they kind of, they look similar. They fight similar.
Yeah, there is quite a few similarities, to be fair, now you've mentioned it. It just shows the level of the training from both gyms.
Yep.
They're producing two lads that are putting on a good show, to be fair. Quite a technical show.
And lovely leg kick.
That was a nice return to the head, though. Elliot's just got to be careful he doesn't get caught with them hands down.
I can't believe how professional both of these guys look, being, you know, this is an amateur fight, yeah. And they're both feeling each other out. Different looks, different styles, switching stance, testing different pacing, timing.
Yeah, no, it's quite a high level for amateur fighters.
They match very similar. I mean, neither fighter's really thrown a lot of hands. All kicks, all. Both slipped.
Neither, to be fair, have even tried to take it to the floor.
Yep.
Both going from a 10th plant in Gracie Baja. It's you'd be expecting them to. But right now, they're just wanting to stand and bang. Which
lovely.
I am grateful for. I'm quite enjoying these.
Now we're letting the hands
lovely
go.
Lovely exchanges.
Elliot Winfield going high with the kicks. Looking for a Superman off the cage, then briefly.
Bit of Showtime Pettis.
Winiowski settling in. Shake and bake. Instruction from the 10th Planet corner. Not really sure what that means. I'm sure it's code for something important.
As long as Elliot understands, then that's the main thing. 5 seconds left the first round. It's been a.
I mean, we could be at a taekwondo tournament. What it's great.
They're kicking way too high for me.
I'm pulling my groin just thinking about it. I'm so old, I've lost my glasses. Just an old man move, that is. They're falling down. Just old.
I don't know, I can't even see.
Sure, I'll find him in the break. Someone's probably borrowed them.
Someone's run off with your glasses.
Wow. That was, I mean, what a way to open up this fight. Elliot Winfield versus Jack Winiarski. We saw so many kicks exchanged. Both fighters, moments where they slipped, landed on the floor. Mm-hmm. Nobody's throwing hands. Nobody's doing takedowns. I feel like there was a backstage agreement just to follow the International Taekwondo Federation rules.
And just kick each other.
Just kick each other. Yeah. Sore legs tomorrow. But the question is, how do you score that? I mean, the slip that the crowd cheered for wasn't really anything.
It's a very tight round, to be honest, because neither had any significant advantage over the other. Although, to be fair, Jack did have some nice boxing up against the cage towards the latter part of the first round. But the kicks have been very heavy and dominant. Jack's had some success with them leg kicks. You can see the marks on Elliot's legs.
Yep.
Part of me thinking that maybe start going back to that instead of getting drawn. Yeah, you know, as I said that.
Oh, that kick up the middle was nice.
Ooh.
Yeah, both. Oh, I'm a bit scared to say this because then we might see a knockout, but both of them did such a good job of staying safe, keeping their hands up, always being in a good position, good shape, good stance.
Footwork's very nice from both of them.
Yeah, polished. They don't look like the kind of debut amateur level. They look like this is
eight to ten
or something.
It'll be impressive to see both of these guys when they're on fights 8 to 10 and starting looking to turn towards pro.
When he asks his corner and now calling for his hands a bit more.
He's starting to put pressure on. He's starting to land some heavier shots.
Oh, now Winiarski's letting his hands go. Does he have an advantage in the boxing? A couple of times he's coming with the kicks and finished with a punch. Having some couple of moments and then being the one doing the pressure, just slightly more. There's also fatigue. How much will that make a difference? Nice kick.
Nice if Elliott started to commit to his punches a bit more. His kicks are looking nice, but his kicks will start landing a lot more if he actually threw some punches.
Oh, like that. This is why Mr. James Pullen is such a good coach.
See, just get the jab in his face.
I think that affected Winiarski as well. He's just immediately backing up.
Well, he's got to be looking to level change highs and lows.
Yeah. Oh! Off the dome.
Elliott's starting to turn up the pressure.
Winfield's just got to use his hands more. He's having great success with it.
Still plenty of time to go in the round, but Elliott is starting to... Oh, lovely body shot by Elliott. Nice inside leg. They're starting to wear. It's like chopping down the tree. Eventually it will fall.
This is interesting. Oh, nice.
Nice return by Jack. Jeez, what a back and forth fight. This is amazing. I'm pretty impressed so far, boys.
Winiarski combination. Winfield, oh, lovely inside leg kick, goes high.
What a scrap.
What a scrap.
Oh, he's going for the Superman off the cage as well.
Winiarski's awfully circling towards Winfield's power.
Well, wow.
Two rounds that somebody has to score.
I wouldn't like to be a judge on that fight.
You know.
So this is...
Normally I have an opinion of, slightly that way, slightly that way. But I have no idea on this one.
No, I'm with you there. Both had success. Both got hit. Both landed beautiful shots.
Winfield looks... Is he smiling? Grimacing. He's got... both fighters are having the most success where their hands go on the end of these combinations, opening with the kicks, closing the distance. And I can see Chris Mee in the corner of Winfield saying, look, let's follow these kicks up with hands.
Yeah, I was just about to say, do you reckon he was saying kick there? Just started kicking the air.
It was a kick punch, and I think that's what he needs. He does need a little bit of a kick punch. Let's use those kicks to, sometimes you throw a kick to the body, to the leg, somebody will drop their hands, you throw it, and then you finish up with your punching combination. And I was fully expecting Elliott Winfield to try and use his well-known jiu-jitsu techniques to the floor, look for a submission, but oh no.
Neither of them have, to be fair. Neither of them really pushed any form of takedown. Just looking to strike. Ooh. Elliott's looking confident, not wanting to get out the centre of the cage. Nice jab to start.
Oh! Winfield eats a shot, saw his head knocked back. Winiarski barreling forwards, but gotta be careful. This drop is, Winfield drops that lead hand. Slip! Since the grappling.
Now we're going to see where Elliott wanted it.
Oh, a little restless sit out. Dives on a Kimura trap, but gives up his back. Very interesting.
Getting to the kick. Nice. Smart move, Jack. Smart move.
Winiarski wants it on the floor. Very nice work by Winiarski. Arms slowly working out of danger. He's on top.
Got to start looking out.
He's trying to wrap up those legs.
Not looking good here. Jack's starting to get in. He's taking the mount. If he can keep Elliott's head against the cage, this is not going to be a good...
Yeah. It's round three. It's slippy. Elliott Winfield clearly very athletic and burst out of this position. Winiarski's having none of it. Great grappling.
Just showing what looks to be a little bit of the stronger frame towards the latter stages of the fight. It's just...
Oh, looking for a choke then, briefly as well. Andre Winner right in the corner here, giving advice to Winiarski. Oh, Elliott gives up his back trying to escape. He can still use it to escape. Is he going to try and turn in? He is.
He's doing well.
He is. Gives up the mount again. Beautiful jiu-jitsu, but Winiarski's ready for it. Oh, big shots.
Just heavy shots from Jack there. Savage ground and pound.
Yep. Winfield doing everything well. Oh, and lockdown. Ted Plant special.
Credit to Elliott. He's staying in there after them heavy shots. Yeah. You can see across his body and his leg that he's been the war here.
Both lads will know they've been in a fight tonight.
Yeah. So what we saw earlier tonight, this lockdown position trying to escape. And I love the lockdown position for standard no-gi jiu-jitsu, even in the gi. But when you're allowed to hit in the head, you just don't. You have no defense left when you're reaching underneath.
Changes the whole dynamic.
Yeah. Winfield looking for a sweep.
Oh, he nearly got it.
Winyowski setting up a head and arm position, but it's going to be very tough when you're inside the guard. Winyowski's calling for a strong finish. They know that they could possibly be two rounds down. I mean, nobody knows, to be honest.
No.
No.
Although, to be fair, in this round, Jack is definitely...
Oh, yeah, all over this.
Winning this round.
Huge round for...
It'd just be interesting to see how the judges do score the first two, to be fair. I give Elliot his props, though.
Yeah, no quitting him.
No.
A beautiful technique.
An 18-year-old lad, he's showing fight years beyond his age.
Great. Wow, what a round. What a round.
What a fight. What a fight. Three good fights so far tonight.
And that's the thing, that round was... It wasn't a 10-8 in my opinion. It wasn't a domination by Winyowski. It's clearly a Winyowski round. So then, if that's a 10-9, and we have a 10-point must system in MMA, so the judges must pick a win in the first two rounds.
Yep.
If they picked Winfield for the first two rounds, we could actually see Winfield win this. And then that's one of the crap things about the MMA judging system, because, you know, in my mind, two rounds are basically draws, and then a round for Winyowski means Winyowski wins the fight. But we have criteria, we have ways that this is judged.
Don't I know it?
And it's, don't you know it? This is very true. It's a very tough sport.
It is a tough sport.
Yeah, you have to play to the rules sometimes. You have to play to the scoring criteria. We need to fix the 10-point must system as well. That should be, we should be using all 10 points would be the main thing. We should have 10-5 rounds, or 10-6 rounds, 10-7 rounds. And, you know, that could be a 10-6 and the first two were 10-9 and you'd get a fair winner. But here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise. What a great contest that was.
Very good fight. Very good fight.
This contest was sponsored by Fisticuffs Podcast. So, after three rounds of action, we go to your judges' scorecard for a decision. And all three judges have it as a unanimous decision for the fighter in the blue corner.
I think the fighter definitely won. That was the right decision. Yeah. Finished on top. Raining down shots.
It was close going into the third, but Jack just pulled away at the end.
Keep talking, Jim.
That's cool.
Here with your winner, Jack Winarski. Wow, that's all I can say about that fight. Absolute throwing leather, throwing kicks, shins from the word go. Did you expect it to be such a grueling fight like that?
No, to be honest. I thought I knew he'd have a sort of a good grappling background, or at least that's what I expected. Seeing him kicking there, wow, kid knows how to kick. Yeah, had some really good shots landed in the first round. He, you know, he tapped me a little bit in the second round with something over the top. Not sure what it was, but I was very, very impressed with his striking. I think I could tell he was getting tired. Towards the third round, you know, I felt fresh enough and I could just see him blowing. So I knew that was a round. I didn't want to do it via grappling, but you got to do what you got to do sometimes, because it didn't really go my way in the second round. So I thought, you know what? Let's show I can do jiu-jitsu. Let's show I can do it.
Well, I wanted to ask you about that. Were you surprised at yourself? I know I certainly was, given the guys from 10th Planet. How well you controlled him on the bit, and you look on the ground, you look like you were the 10th Planet guy.
Yeah, honestly, whenever I do roll with people, obviously you tend to find it with jiu-jitsu players. This is no disrespect to jiu-jitsu, please. But you tend to find they like to be on their back, they like to work off their back. So I'm very comfortable being in top position. And in the fight there, you know, he was trying to throw things up, he was trying to slide away, but I could just feel, you know, all that muscle lot of oxygen, man. I need a lot of oxygen to breathe and move around. There just wasn't anything coming back. I felt very comfortable there, yeah.
And then finally, what a corner. Melissa Dixon, James Dixon. How much of this do you owe to these guys in the gym that get you through each day and keep you on pushing?
Everything. Absolutely everything. You know, I started coming to the gym about a year ago. You know, thought I knew a lot more than I did. Bit of an ego on me. These guys, they push you every day. They show you the right techniques. They're a great laugh to be around, you know. Out the back there, I've never felt more relaxed. Everybody laughing and joking. Just letting me do my thing to warm up. And are you going to get a better amateur corner? Are you ever going to get a better corner in amateur MMA? Andre Winner, tough finalist. James Dixon, absolute monster who no one wants to fight. No one wants to fight him. I know he's got an opponent now, but generally, there's a lot of bitches out there, aren't there? And then Melissa Dixon on Aries. She's going to be in the UFC by the end of next year, for
100%, 100%.
Sure. 100%.
Yeah. Well, well done. Absolutely great fight. Thank you very much. And can't wait to see more of you. Jack Wanowski, ladies and gentlemen. And thanks, Jack. Back to you, Chris and James. Thank you.